playing around on my computer and seeing what creative things I can do. It's like one of those outlets for me. Like even if I wasn't in education, I still feel like I would love just playing around and creating on different applications like that. So I'm gonna show you what I am making today. On the Adobe Creative Cloud Express, you possibly have a login with your school, so double check. This is just such an incredible program. You can remove background, which is always so helpful, something that I do with my students for PowerPoints. I love that you can convert GIFs as well, and then do some average editing things like resizing images. They have a lot of different templates for the classroom, which is really nice. I actually like that for teaching the students about keyboard basics. The posters is something that I'm going to be doing today for an advisory activity that I'm going to show you in a second. They also have flyers, which is really helpful. I also really like the infographics. That's something that my students use in the classroom. We did that with figurative language. You can do that like with the Holocaust unit, for Diary of Anne Frank. For teachers, the resumes is incredible if you want to update that. And then there's also worksheets. I've used the bingo before. We did bingo in advisory. It's such a fun idea if you want to do like a bingo sheet about your school and you make the answers things that have to do with the school. So you're also asking trivia questions, and if they know the answer, they'll put it on their sheet. The backgrounds are super cute. My students love that stuff. And then there's just little things like lesson plans and report cards. So let's go back up to the top. We're gonna start today with the posters. I'm gonna say create from this template. So advisory is a time when students can come together and reflect in a small group. It's always the same group. We have it for about 10 minutes a day, and then we have a longer period once a week where it's about 40 minutes. And what I love about that is, one, they're getting that emotional connection where they can really check in with each other and have a little bit of fun and do something that's not related to academics, since there is such a push during the day to go from subject to subject. So it says my perfect spring break, but I'm actually going to change that. Things that bring me joy. I want this to be a conversation about spring break, but maybe over spring break, things that we did, that we had time for, that we realized brought us joy. Because not every student is going to have the same opportunity to do the same thing as another student in class over spring break. But I think everyone can relate to finding joy when you are given a break. When you don't have to be on all the time or studying or doing homework, what are the things that brought you joy? So I'm gonna look at what they already have, and what's so great about this is like I already changed the font, and if I don't like the color, I could change that up a little bit. If you go to text color, they kind of have a palette right now, which I like, and I really like this green, but if I want to change the orange, like, and then I might change the circle on the background. I actually really like the circle. Yeah, I'm gonna go like that. Okay, so read a book I love. I think that is something that we are trying to promote, getting students to find joy in independent reading. So I think that's wonderful. I'm going to leave that. I'm also going to leave eat ice cream, like fabulous. I think go swimming is great. Yellowstone National Park, I'm going to take out. It's something I actually really want to do, but I don't know if every student casually had an opportunity to go there. I like go on an adventure. So let's say I want to add something else now. I'm gonna go over to design. I like this fruit. I think it's like a reminder to like try a new recipe or eat something healthy. Oh, I actually like the yoga mat. We talk about meditating a lot, so we'll stick that on there. They love watching different things on TV. Kind of a vintage looking TV, but like it. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is kind of just like move all of this around. So I'm just gonna move the book up a little bit. If they want to do like a real photo similar to the fruit here, they could do that. Another thing that I love is they can actually upload their own photos. So if they got to play with their dog or eat dinner with their family, or breakfast, like so they're not rushed in the morning, they could also include that on here. So this is a really fun activity that you could do with the students because it's getting them to, one, use the computer and use these different tools, but they also can reflect on the things that bring them joy when they have that break. And then this could lead into another discussion, maybe on day three. Just to go backwards a little bit, day one, you probably can introduce Adobe if you haven't done it before and kind of do a tutorial. Like, I love making something as a model. I also just find it therapeutic and fun. So I probably do that on day one and show them that. And then on day two, they can spend 10-ish minutes. It really doesn't take too long working on this. If you need another day or if you have more time in your period, then you can give them like maybe 20 minutes, I think would be good for this. So we'd probably take 1 to 2 days to work on this. Then on the third day, we could present them and talk about them. And the following day, I think there's a really important conversation that could be had about why don't we get to do these things, you know, all the time. And there are some obvious answers like, oh, we just don't have time or we are tired. But then I think the conversation needs to be about the importance of making time to do things that bring us joy. And just looking at this, it makes me so happy. These are all things that bring me joy. And I can compare and contrast with other students if anyone has anything in common with me or if they have anything different. So this one simple program could lead to so many awesome conversations. It seems simple, but it's also teaching them a little bit about aesthetic and putting something together. I actually think it's more important than people realize. When you are making a slideshow for your students, it's important that you are thinking about the font and the sizes and bullet points and just the way that things look. And even on Adobe, I have made slideshows before and they really help me keep things organized. It really helps students see the information in a new way that feels really clean and easy to process. And it's important that they learn that because I remember when I was in school, like sometimes I feel like I would just throw so many different things on a slide, but it's just not practical. But something like this is so much fun. It's almost like a mood board or just a board of joy. And it'll spark a lot of great and authentic conversation. I absolutely love this. And when you're all done, you can just press download and you could show that to the students. I think this would be a really cute bulletin board idea. In the middle, you could actually have things that bring me joy. And then your students don't even need to write that on there. They could just put their name or something in the center. And then you could put that all over the board. This is just an overview of everything. If you have any questions about Adobe, let me know. I feel like I could talk about this forever and ever. And thank you to Adobe for partnering with me.